This book tackles so many different areas, from the Electoral College to gerrymandering to so-called spoiler candidates.
Yes.
But you do it in a way that the typical man or woman out there can digest it and understand. Why tackle these issues?
Well, there's nothing more fundamental, Alex. There's nothing more important. I mean, in order for us to solve the many, many problems that we have today, we have to get government right. And in order to get government right, we've got to get elections right. Mm-hmm. And unfortunately, we have some pretty important structural fundamental flaws in our election system that actually are easily fixed without a constitutional amendment. Mm. We just need to focus on it. And so I wrote a book of scholarship, but it was also directed towards the everyday person, as you said.
So let's tackle one thing in particular, where the power players who are in office have a whole lot of control, and that's gerrymandering,
right,
where they change districts to serve their particular point of view.
Right.
But they're the ones in power who would have to change this. So how do you get people in power to willingly do something that will take away some of their power?
Well, it's an excellent question. We are the only country, industrialized democracy in the world, that allows the politicians to draw their own district lines. A lot of other countries use independent redistricting commissions, for example. And as to how you get them to change it, even though it's in their interest to fight every reform, as we saw in Memphis with instant runoff voting, it was in the incumbent's interest to fight these kinds of reforms.
Right.
There are two different methods. One is the referendum process, ballot initiatives. That's how a lot of these reforms are getting through, because people are, you know, getting the petition signatures and putting things
from a grassroots level.
From a grassroots level, bypassing the politicians and getting referenda reform, which is what we're doing around the country.
Mm. Okay.
Another way is to convince them that it's in their interest. You know, it's in the interest for Republicans in Massachusetts and Democrats in Texas to change the system so that they have more of a voice.
Of a chance, yeah.
Because our winner-take-all system, where 51% of the vote controls 100% of the power, really isn't really good for democracy.
Also talk to us about something that we hear a lot about. A lot of people don't perhaps completely grasp what it is, the Electoral College. Even U.S. Congressman Steve Cohen of Memphis is saying, you know, we need to get rid of it.
Right.
Let's dump it.
Right.
Of course, that might be easier said than done. Your thoughts on that?
Well, it actually definitely needs to go. And the interesting thing about it is that there's a way to do that without a constitutional amendment. A constitutional amendment is almost impossible to do. You need 3/4 of the state legislatures, 2/3 of the House and the Senate. Very, very difficult in cases like this, as you said, where incumbents have a motive to fight reform.
Right.
There's something called the National Popular Vote Interstate Compact, which is an agreement among state legislatures, like a contract, that says, we agree to award all of our electoral votes to whoever wins the overall national vote. And it doesn't become effective until enough states sign on to control 270 electoral college votes and thus the election.
Gotcha.
We've only been trying it for 10 years. We're already 70% of the way there. So I think it's plausible to think that in our lifetime, the Electoral College won't be abolished, but it'll be rendered harmless.
How do you sell it, though, to those who look at the map? And physically, if you look at the map of the United States, it does look like a large number of states vote one way. It's just the states with less population. So yeah. How do you make them understand that?
And a lot of people say, if my candidate wins, I don't really have a problem with the Electoral College.
Which we've seen on both sides.
Yes. Right, right. So a couple of things. First of all, if you take a look at those maps where you go beyond the state level and down to the county level and precinct level, you see that we're mixed of red and blue everywhere. We're not, you know, just blue on the coasts and red in the middle. It's a mixture.
So you have to show the accurate map.
You have to show the accurate map. And then I think you also just need to explain to people that, you know, this time your guy got the benefit of it, but next time it might be the other guy.
Wow.
Makes sense.
It is a fascinating book for sure. Good information.
And we have the event tonight.
Yes. Will you actually be answering questions and that sort of thing?
Yes. Short presentation and then a Q&A, wine and cheese refreshments, and it's at Novel Bookstore at the Laurelwood Shopping Center at 6 p.m.
Got the information right there on the screen.
Great.
And you said wine and cheese.
Yes. So come on down.
Smart man to get people out.
We know.
Thanks so much.